sin more than follow God, and their kingdom was destroyed. Our ancestors were destroyed, and they were sent into captivity, which were part of the blessings and cursings. Do it God's way, blessings. Do it your way, cursings. And all the book, all the blessings and curses came upon them for their disobedience and sinful behavior, following other gods, idols, so on. And there's going to be some battles that you're going to win, and you're going to lose some battles. But you, when you mess up and you sin, you make mistakes, you repent of your sins and ask God to forgive you and move forward. Continuing to follow God and His truth for your life, His playbook, His military strategies for your life. His will and His purpose for your life. He's got a will and He's got a purpose. There's corporate battles that He wants you to win. When it deals with the church as a whole, and there are personal battles that you must deal with to win. But God has it in the scripture. All you have to do is follow His strategies, His tactics, His playbook, His strategy, and you will win. You will have the victory. You will win the battles. You'll lose some. You'll win some too. But God's overall plan is not going to be thwarted. Well, slowly and gradually be Christianized. It really just, for the most part, depends on God, of course, but it also depends on your effort. Because we are very much people who, or we are very much able to, you know, Christianize the world faster or not. It all depends on you and I, and most surely, God. And however long it takes, we can speed the process up or we can slow the process up. Both God and man are involved in the process. Thus, God's purpose and plan will be achieved. Only God knows how long that may take before the world gets Christianized. It may take millions of years. It may take thousands of years. Only God knows. There'll be periods of progression for the church and periods of recession for the church. And people have a choice to respond to the light of truth or not. But men love darkness rather than light, as it says in John chapter 1. But we will win. We will triumph. The Bible says it. I've read the back of the book, the end of the book. And it says what it says, and what is written is written, and it's going to be achieved. And there's going to be battles, but you're going to win. And there's going to be battles that you're going to lose, but God is the one that ultimately gives you the victory. You follow His truth, His will, His purpose for your life. You will triumph. You will have victory in your life. constantly listening to God's truth, listening to what he has to say, what he wants to speak to you as you read and study his word of God. But you got to get the word of God. You got to study the word of God. You got to pray to God. You got to listen to him. You got to get in the church so you can be around brothers and sisters that will help you have victory. Some group doesn't necessarily have to be a building. It could be a group. In that chapter we looked at, that sometimes deception is necessary. God told the Israelites to use deception. So sometimes lying is necessary to preserve the greater good, the higher good. If, for instance, example is if you were back in World War II and you lived in Germany and you were hiding some Jews in your basement and the SS or a Nazi member came to your door and banged on the door and asked you if you have any Jews in your house, you'd lie and say, no, I don't have no Jews. You're not going to say, oh yeah, I got some Jews. You know, I mean, and there was a lot of Christians during World War II that hit some Jews and said, well, no, I don't have no Jews. You're not going to say, oh yeah, I got a whole bunch of Jews because I can't lie because God doesn't want me to lie. No. In this instance, if you were to tell them where those Jews were at, you would not be doing, you would not be obedient to God.